Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. Most people learn to add starting from the rightmost column. For instance, let's take this number. 537 plus 198. So the usual way they teach this in school is you start over here on the right, which is in the ones column. 7 plus 8 is 5, but then you have to write the 5 and carry the 1. And this is where a lot of people get confused. They might put the 1 and carry the 5, getting it backwards. But anyway, most people learn how to do it without too much problem. And so we add 1, 3, and 9. That would be 13. You carry the 1, and that gives you 7. So there's no problem with that. But I'm going to show you a way to add these numbers going from left to right where you don't have to do the carrying. So here's how it works. And I'm going to write the different place values in different colors. So I'm going to put the 5s in green and the 10s. I'm sorry, the hundreds in green. I'm going to put the tens places, which is the 3 and the 9 in purple, and I'm going to put the ones here to illustrate something, how I'm doing it, so you can see how I'm adding from left to right. So I'm starting adding from left to right. I just go 5 plus 1, which is 6. I just write the 6 down, no problem. Now, the next column is 3 plus 9. Now watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to go down and I'm going to write 3 plus 9 is 12, right? I'm just going to write it here. Okay? Then I'm going to go to the 7, 8, 7 plus 8, and that is 15, and there's room to put it here, so I'm going to just write 15. So I'm kind of lining up my numbers, although the 1 and the 2 don't look perfectly lined up. And then I'm going to do it again. So now I just add the 6 and 1 is 7. I'm sorry, yes, the 1 and the 2 add up to 3 and the 5. And notice I get the same answer. So what you do is you add, and if there's no room to write the number, I just go below and write it, and then if I have room, I could write it up here again. So let's do another problem. All right, so here's another problem. Let's go ahead and just add from left to right. I didn't put it in different colors this time, so hopefully you can follow along. 8 and 9 is 17, so I just write 17. 5 and 8 is 13, so I need two places, so I'm just going to go below here to write the 13. Are you with me there? And then 6 and 2 is 8. Now, it doesn't matter where you put it. You could put it here or you could put it next to the 3. The idea is that you're just writing the number down. And now we're going to do it again. If there's two rows like this, you just add one more time. So that's 1, 8, 3, 8. And there you go. You ready to try one? How about 537 plus 648? All right, so why don't you try that one on your own by putting the video on pause and trying it on your own? All right, so this time 5 and 6 is 11, so we write 11. 3 and 4 is 7. I don't need to go below here. Do you see that? Because there's room to put it right here. I could just put the 7 right there. And then the 7 and 8 is 15. I could just write the 15 right here. Now, some people actually write the 1 here and the 5 up here. It really doesn't matter. What matters is you've got in the right column. You want to write 1, 5. So we have to add one more time since we have two rows. So we have 1, 1, 8, 5. Voila, I've added from left to right. Now, what I like about this method is, first of all, we usually read left to right, so that seems natural. We don't have this problem with the carrying thing where you write down the ones number and then have to put the tens up at the next place. So you get to stay kind of at your eye level, you know, when you're writing, and you get to go left to right. You don't have to worry about adding three numbers at a time. Right? Because you just do your carrying. This is kind of like doing your carrying at the end of the problem. Okay, let's try this one. So we're just going from left to right. So first of all, I just have the 7 in the thousands place. So we write the 7. And then we've got 9 and 8, so let's just write 17 right here. We have 8 and 9, I'm sorry, 8 and 1, which is 9. And then 6 and 5 is 11. And now we have to add again. So 7 and 1 is 8. 7 goes here. But check this out. We have 9 and 1 is 10, so I have to write 10, which means I have to add one more time. 8, 8, 0, 1. I realize this takes a little bit more time. It's just an alternative way of doing addition. You certainly don't have to do it if you're comfortable with carrying and always get the problem right with carrying. It does take less space on your paper, so it's a perfectly good way to do it. But I like this method especially for people who have trouble with the carrying and only like to add two numbers at a time. So let's do another one. All right, so why don't you try this one? You're going to go from left to right. Put the video on pause, try it, and then see how you do. Here we go. 5 and 8 is 13. 6 and 6 is 12. I'm just going to write it like this, 12. 9 and 9 is 18, so I'm just going to go here since I have room. And 3 and 7 is 10. I'm going to go write it down here. I'm going to add again one more time. 1, 4, 3, 9, 0. Okay, this also works if you're adding more than two numbers together. So let's try one of those now. So now we have three numbers to add, and we'll still go left to right. I'm going to do each column in a different color. So the 5, 8, and 4, so you can see what happens again. What is that? So unfortunately, I have to add these three numbers. So that's 13 plus 4 is 17. So I'm going to write 17. Okay. The next column, I have 3, 6, and 2. That's 11, so I'm just going to write 11 right here. And the next column I'll do in purple, 2, 5, and 8. That's 7 and 8 is 15, so I'm just going to put the 15 like this. And then we add up, 1, 8, 2, 5. It really doesn't take much more time than doing it the way with carrying, but just an alternative. All right, so here's one for you to try, three numbers. Okay, so try this problem. Put the video on pause and try that on your own. All right, let's do it, starting going from left to right. 9 and 5 and 7, that's 21. Okay. 8, 3 and 7, that's 18. So I'm just going to write the 18 here. 6, 8, and 6, that adds up to 20. And so we have to do it again, add. 2, 2, I have 2 and 8 is 10, so I just have to write the 10 one more time. This is still 0, right? So we get 2, 3, 0, 0, 2300. Let's add four numbers. All right, so here are four numbers to add. We're just going to go left to right again. So let's see, 5, 6, 10, 12. That's 5, 1, and 4, and 2 adds up to 12. Next column, I've got 6 and 6 and 2, so that's 12, 13, 14. So I'm going to go down here to fit in that 14. 2, 5, 2, and 3, what's that? 9, 10, 11, 12. So I have room to put that here, 12. 4, 3, 5, and 6, that's 18. So I'm going to put the 18 here. And then we just add one more time, 1, 3, 5, 3, 8. And there it is. All right, so hopefully you learned something new. And if you know anybody having trouble with addition, with carrying, you might show them this method. Or if you know any teachers, know any kids, or just somebody who wants to have fun with math. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.